So in the previous module, we have applied the state space representation to electrical and the mechanical system. We also learn how to convert a transfer function representation into the state space representation. Now one advantage of this state space representation is that it can be used for the simulation of physical system. It can be used for the simulation of physical system on digital computers. On digital computers. Now, if we want to simulate any system that is represented by the transfer function, if we want to simulate any system that is represented by the transfer function, then we must convert the transfer function representation into the state space representation. Okay. So any transfer function is given, and if we want to convert it into state space form, so we must convert this transfer function representation to the state space representation. First of all, we select the variables, state variables, which are also known as the phase variables. We select the state variables, which are also called the phase variables, where each subsequent state variable is defined to be derivative of the previous state variable. Now in this case, first of all, we represent a general nth order differential, linear differential equation with constant coefficients, represent it in state space in the phase variable form. That is, we take the nth order differential equation, we take the nth order differential equation, and then with the constant coefficients, we write it in the state space form, in state space and in the phase variable form. State space and phase variable. Now let us consider a differential equation. Let us consider a differential equation, nth order differential equation. Now the convenient way to choose the state variables is to choose the output yt and its derivatives as the state variables that we have already discussed. This choice is called the phase variable choice. Choosing the state variable xi, we get. So what we do, we choose the state variable output and its derivatives, which are the state variables in this case. Now in this case, we see that output is y. So we take x1 equals to y, x2 equal to dy by dt, x3 equal to d square y by dt square, and xn equal to dn minus 1 y divided by dt n minus 1. Okay. So we take the output, that is, and choose its derivatives as the state variables. And this choice is known as the phase variable choice. Okay. So now from this, what we do, we differentiate both the sides, that is, we differentiate this dv by dt. We differentiate this dv by dt, then it would be equal to x dot. X dot represents the differentiation with respect to time. It is x dot, x1 dot. Then second time we differentiate d square y by dt square equals to x2 dot that is we differentiate this, then we differentiate this x3, we get x3 dot and differentiate n terms, then we get xn dot in this case. Now from these two values, that is these two, this one and this one, we can see that dy by dt is equal to x1 dot here. So dy by dt equal to x2. So x1 dot is equals to x2. Okay. This x1 dot is equals to x2. Again, this x2 dot is equals to x3. Now we get x1 dot equal to x2, x2 dot equal to x3, xn minus 1 dot equal to xn, and xn dot is this equation. So comparing these two equations, we get this values, and xn dot is equals to this value. We substitute these, replace these values in this equation, that is, we replace dn minus 1 y divided by dn minus 1 equals to xn dash. Similarly, same values are replaced, and finally we are getting xn dash this value. Now in the vector matrix form, it can be represented as this x1 dot to xn dot, and then again we have x1, x2, x3, xn, these are the state variables, then b not u. So it is of the form of ax plus bu, that is the state variable form. Now this is the state variable form of the state equations, that is, this form is known as the state variable form, state variable form of state equations. Now the plus point of this form is that this form is easily recognized by a unique pattern of 1 and zeros. So this is easily recognized by the pattern of 1 and zeros in this matrix, and the negative of coefficients of differential equation, which are written in the reverse order in the last row of the system matrix. Okay, so this form, if we want to identify this form, it can be easily identifiable by pattern of 1 and zeros, and also the negative of coefficients of the differential equation written in the reverse order in the last row of the system matrix. Finally, the solution of differential equation of the output equation is equals to, as we know that y in this case is equals to x1. So since in that form, output form, we also have to include other state variables, so in the matrix form it can be written as 1 and all the elements are 0, and these are the state variables. So to convert a transfer function into state equations in phase variable form, first we convert the transfer function into the differential equation. We take the transfer function, we convert it into differential equation by cross multiplying and taking the inverse Laplace transform, assuming the zero initial conditions. Then we represent the differential equation in the state space in the phase variable form. Okay, so for any problem in which we have to convert the transfer function into state equations, first we convert that transfer function into differential equation by cross multiplying and taking the inverse Laplace transform while assuming the zero initial condition, and then we represent the differential equation in state space in the phase variable form, and this can be illustrated by example. Now let us take an example in which we have to convert a transfer function with the constant term in the denominator, that is we have the constant term in the denominator, that is 24 in this case. First of all we find the associated differential equation. We first of all write the transfer function of the system, that is output divided by input in this case. So this is the transfer function which is given here. Then we cross multiplying, that is CS is cross multiplied with this denominator and RS with 24. Now the corresponding differential equation, then after that what we do, we take the inverse Laplace transform of this equation and get the equation in the time domain, and the corresponding differential equation is found by taking the inverse Laplace transform assuming the zero initial condition. From this itself we can say that it's in an order 3, so it's a order 3, then we have 9 C double dot, then we have a 26 C dot plus 24 C in this case equals to 24 R, which is in here in time domain. Okay, now our first step is over, that is take that Laplace transform and then use the inverse Laplace transform and represent that equation in the time domain. Now step 2, we have to select the state variables as we have done in the previous case also, choosing the state variables as successive derivatives. So we get in this case x1, we have this xc c dot c double dot. So for x1 we take c, for the derivative of c we can take x2, and for the derivative of this double derivative of c we take x3. Now differentiating these equations, that is we know that x1 equal to c, x2 equal to c dot, and x3 equal to c double dot, we differentiate this equation, we get x1 dot equal to c1 dot, but c1 dot equal to x2, then x2 dot equal to c double dot, but c double dot equal to x3, and x3, that is differentiation of this, equal to c triple dot. This c triple dot can be obtained by this previous equation, that is c triple dot is obtained by this previous equation. From this equation we see that c triple dot equal to minus 24 c minus 26 c dot minus 9 c double dot plus 24 r, but we know that c is equals to x1, c dot equal to x2, and c double dot equal to x3. So replacing here, finally we are getting x3 dot equal to minus 24 x1 minus 26 x2 minus 9 x3 plus 24 r. Finally we are getting this, we differentiate this equation and then represent it in this way. Okay, that is these equations we get from this, and last equation we get from this one. Okay, now finally we have y equals to, that is output equal to y equals to c, which is also in this case is x1. Now in the matrix form it can be, these three equations can be written as to form the this state vector, that is x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot, and then in the matrix, and then we have state variables x1, x2, x3, then 0, 0, 24 and r, which is actually the input, and y in this case equals to x1. So in this we have to include the state variables also. So it is 1 0 0 x1 x2 and x3. Okay, now from this one more observation can be made that third row of the system matrix, that is this third row of the system matrix, have the same coefficients as the denominator of the transfer function. It has the same coefficients as the denominator of the transfer function, which is written in the reverse order. That is, they are negative and written in the reverse order. So these have the same coefficients as the denominator of the this transfer function, which are reversed and negative and in reverse order. Now we represent it as an equivalent block diagram of the system. To represent it, first of all we draw three integral blocks would be there, and for these three integral blocks we label each output, that is x3, x2 and x1, as one of the state variables. So we take the three integral blocks first of all, and then x3, x2 and x1, they are labeled as one of the state variables. As we know that from this, that the differentiator of this, when we differentiate it x1 we get x2, when we differentiate x2 we got x3. So similarly we can say that when this x3 dot it is integrated we get x3, then x3 is integrated, so x3 in this case is x2 dot. Okay, so when x3 is integrated it is x, that is this x3 is equals to x2. When this x3 is integrated, so it gives only, rather than x2 dot, it gives only x2 as shown here, it gives only x2. Then we know that this x2 is equals to x1 dot. When we integrate this x2 we get as x1 only. That is, when we integrate this x2 we get x1 only. And we also know that this x1 is equal to y, this x1 is equal to y. Okay, so this is output, this x1 is equals to y. So these equations are represented, this can be represented, this has already, we have already represented, then x2 we have already represented. Now this y equal to c equals to x1, it has already been represented here. Now we are left with only this equation, that is x3 dot. So x3 dot can be obtained by the differentiation of x3. However, when we integrate this x3 dot we get x3 only. Okay, now here we have x3. Okay, when we differentiate it, so we get x3 dot, and x3 dot when we integrate that we get x3. Now x3 is the combination of different terms. Here we see that x3 is the combination of minus 24 x1, that is minus x1 is here, minus 24 x1, then minus 26 x2, then minus 26 x2, then we have minus 9 x3, then minus 9x3. Minus is included here in the summer because whatever we have discussed in this block diagram representation, it is we have applied here that it is negative. Okay, so and the last term is plus 24 r. R in this case is the input. Then we have to multiply this r with again 24 and then add all the three, all other three signals. So finally, we are getting this x3 in this case. So we are getting this. So this is the final block diagram representation of this transfer function. That is, we have converted the transfer function with the constant term in the numerator into block diagram representation. Some observation can be made out of that this last term is actually the coefficients of denominator, negative coefficients of denominator in the reverse order, and we have also represented in a block diagram. And now we have discussed the case which has constant term in the numerator. Now, if the transfer function has the polynomial in S is in the numerator and it has the order less than the polynomial in the denominator, like you see that it has the numerator has the order 2 and it has the order 3 in this case. So what we do? We separate the transfer function into two cascade forms. That we separate the transfer function into the two cascade forms if it is of that form. That is, this is the first form and this is the second form. Okay, that is it represents the denominator only and it represents the numerator only, and as per the block diagram, if we multiply both, then it would be this one. Okay. Now, in this case, you see that this transfer function will, with just the denominator, is converted into phase variable representation in state space, as we have discussed in the last example also. Simply, we convert it into phase variable form of the state space. Okay, now in this case we take, as we have done in the previous case also, we take x1 as the input, output. We take x1 in this case as the output that we have discussed in the previous example also, and other two variables, that is x2s and x3s, are the internal variables in this case. Okay, as we have taken x1 as the output, as also in the previous case we have taken x1 as the output. Okay, and other two variables are the internal variables. Okay, now second transfer function with only numerator, second transfer function with only numerator, it yields CS by x1s as this. So CS is equals to this into x1s. Okay, now after taking the inverse Laplace transform with the zero initial conditions, we get this is output. So this yt equals to b2 d square x1 by dt square plus b1 dx1 by dt plus b naught x1. Okay, but this d square x1 by dt square dx1 by dt, these derivative terms are the definitions of the phase variables in the first block also. That is, we have variables x1, x2 and x3 in the first block. So these are simply the definition of the variables in the first block. So substituting these in this equation, that is here x1 dx1 by dt we substitute as x2, then d square x by dt square we substitute as x3, and we write it in the reverse order. That is y t equals to b naught x 1 plus b 1 x 2 plus b 2 x 3. So the second block simply forms a specified linear combination of state variables developed in the first block. So this is only the linear combination of the state variables in the first block, that is this numerator is only the linear combination of state variables developed in the first block. So what observations can be made out of that? From that we have the observations that the denominator of the transfer function yields the state equation as we have discussed in the last problem, while the numerator yields the output equation only. So this gives us the state equation, and that is denominator gives us the state equation and this numerator gives us the output equation. So if we have the transfer function in which it is numerator is not constant, then it can be handled in this way. So we will discuss with some problem. Now let us consider a system. We have to find the state space representation of transfer function. So we, in this case, we have to convert a transfer function with the polynomial in the numerator. Okay. Now what we do, first we represent it into two cascade forms. That is, this is the denominator in this case and this is the numerator in this case. This is the denominator and this is the numerator in this case. The first step is to separate the system into two cascade blocks. First block contains the denominator and the second block contains the numerator in this case. Now after that, what we do, we represent this. Now in this problem and the previous problem, the both are this problem and the previous problem is like that this denominator and the previous case we have 24 in the this numerator. Okay, other things remains the same. So we find out the we find out and take the state space representation, and it can be written as the negative of the coefficients of the denominator, and in this case, since in the we have first block numerator in this case is previously it was 24 and this case we have 1 only, so in the input we have 1 only. Now this is about the denominator. Now what we do. Now in the second block we have output is cs and input is x1s. So output is equals to s square plus 7s plus 2 into x1s. That is, comparing with the previous example, this in that case we have b naught equals to 2, b1 equals to 7 and b2 in this case is equals to 1. Now we take the inverse Laplace transform with the zero initial conditions. We get C is equal to x1 double dot plus 7x1 dot plus 2x1. But we know that x1 equals to x1, x1 dot equals to x2 and x1 double dot equals to x3 in this case. So substituting the value of x1 double dot, x1 dot in this equation, finally we are getting x3 plus x2 plus 2x1. Now this output that we have represented like in the previous problem, output is given by this equation. So this is, that is b naught, b1 and b2, x1, x2, x3. Here we know that b naught is equals to 2, b1 equals to 7 and b2 equals to 1. So that is how we have found that. And now the final state is to find the block diagram representation of the system. Now, whatever we have done in the previous example also, first of all, we label that as x1, x2 and x3. And now we know that if we integrate this x2, we get this x1. Okay, we integrate x3 because x3 is x2 dot, then we get x2. And if we integrate, if we differentiate x3, we get x3 dot, and if we integrate x3, we get x3. Now with the first block, almost the values are same in this case. So first of all, we label these, this one and this one, we label this, and we represent it like that. Now in this case, we know that x3 dot is equals to 24 minus 24 x1 minus 26 x2 minus 9 x3 plus r into 1. So it is represented similarly. In this case, previously it was 24, now it is 1 only, and it is represented by this summer block. Now this is the case of denominator. This we have considered only when the denominator is considered. Now for representing the numerator, since the numerator is the linear combination of the state variables, as we see that it's the combination of x3 plus x2 plus 2x1, so to get the output, so it is the linear combination, so we have to get the signal from s3, we have to get the signal from x2, we have to get the signal from 2x1 to get the y, that is the output in this case. Finally, it is represented by, that is x3, 1 into x3, then we have x2, 7 into x2, then we have x1, 2 into x1, both are added in a summer, and we are finally getting this yt. So this is how the numerator is handled in this case in the block diagram, and this is how the denominator is handled. Okay. Now we have converted the state space, we have converted the transfer function into state space form. Now we move in the opposite direction and convert the state space representation into the this transfer function form. As we know that these are the state, it is a state equation, and this is the output equation. Now we take the Laplace transform of this equation, assuming the zero initial condition, that is x dot the Laplace transform of this, and zero initial conditions are zero in this case, axs plus bus, then ys is given by cxs plus dus, and we solve for xs in this case. So s in this case, and then we have the identity matrix I in this case, minus a, minus this a into xs is equals to bus, or we can say that xs is this inverse, this value inverse, si minus a inverse into bus. So I in this case is the identity matrix. Now substituting this xs in this equation, in this output equation, we get ys is equals to C into SI minus A inverse BUS plus DUS, and finally rearranging that, we get CSI minus A inverse B plus D into US in this case, where U in this case is the input. Now also this matrix, that is CSI minus A inverse B into B plus D, is called the transfer function matrix, since it relates the output, that is YS, to the input, that is US. However, if US equals to scalar US and YS equals to scalar YS, that these are scalars, we can find out the transfer function. The transfer function is given by, that is TS is equals to CS I identity matrix minus A inverse B plus D. So in this way we can get the transfer function from the state space representation. So we will discuss with the example. Now let us consider the problem in which we have to convert we have to convert the form state space representation into the transfer function. This is x dot equals to this and y equal to this. It is of the form of ax plus bu and y equal to cx plus du. Now to find the find the transfer function of the system, we must know these terms, that is c into si minus a inverse b plus d. This b, d and c are already known to us, so we have to calculate only si minus a inverse. So this c, b and d, that is already known. In this case you see that it is represented in terms of ax plus bu and y equals to cx plus du. So d is 0 in this case. So this matrix is the A matrix, this is the B matrix, this is the C matrix, and d is 0 in this case. So we have to find the value of si minus a, that is si identity matrix minus a is this matrix. Then we have to find its inverse. Inverse can be obtained by adjoint and the determinant of this. We get this as an inverse of that. Then b is given by this 10 0 0, then c we have 1 0 0, and d equal to 0 in this case. And substituting this in this transfer function, finally we get that ts equals to 10 s square plus 3 s plus 2 and divided by s cube plus 3 s square plus 2 s plus 1. So this is the final transfer function of the system. This is how the state space representation can be, state space can be converted into transfer function. So in this lecture we have discussed the converting a transfer function into state space, that how the transfer function can be converted into state space, state variables form of the state equation, and after that we have discussed a problem also, that it we have converted the transfer function with the constant term in the numerator and represent it in the block diagram representation also. Then we have analyzed a system where the numerator is not constant but it is in time domain also, that is S domain also, how to cascade these different terms and how to handle these different terms. That is, we analyze that the denominator yields the state equation while the numerator yields the output equation in this case, and we have discussed it with a small problem in that. Small problem also. After that we convert from the state space to the transfer function, and we found out a transfer function, that how we can with the values of these we can get the transfer function. That is, we have to calculate si minus a in that very case, and other values are given. We have discussed this with small problem also, in which the system can be represented in state form, that is ax plus bu and output, that is y equal to cx plus du, and by finding out the different values, that is si minus a inverse, b, c and d, we can get the transfer function approach. Now here it is all about. Thank you very much for the lecture.